Welcome to My Student Support System. In today's class, we are going to discuss water purification on large scale. This chapter or this topic you can get in examination as in the subject of community health nursing or public health nursing, as well as in the environment health subject. This lecture is in English, and if you want to study in Hindi, just click on I button and you will get link of Hindi lecture, or you can directly visit to my channel, My Student Support System. Water purification. What is water purification? Water purification means making the water clean and safe to drink. Normally, it is discussed or covered under two headings: purification of water on large scale and purification of water on small scale. In this class, we will discuss the purification of water on large scale, while the purification of water on small scale we will discuss in next lecture. Large scale water purification. Large scale water purification is needed to provide safe drinking water to the public. Normally, this is the responsibility of governments to provide continuous and safe water supply. Large-scale water purification needs water treatment plant. And normally, the Water Works Department or PHED Department or municipal corporations or municipal councils, they have the system to purify the water on large scale and supply to the households. The main steps for large scale water purification are as follows: storage, filtration, and disinfection. And we will discuss all these steps one by one. First is storage. Storage provides a reserve for water from the source before starting the process of purification. The water source may be a river or canal which provide continuous water supply to the reservoir or storage. Water is stored in the reservoir till it is used for the next step of purification. As a result of storage, a very considerable amount of purification takes place. This is natural purification. About 90% of the suspended impurities settle down within 24 hours by gravity. Some chemical changes also take place during this storage. The aerobic bacteria oxidizes the organic matter present in the water with the help of dissolved oxygen. By this process, the content of free ammonia is reduced and a rise in nitrates occur. Some time for providing or introducing this oxygen into the water, aeration process is also added in some water treatment plants. On storage, pathogenic organisms gradually die out. It is found by the research that when the river water is stored, the total bacteria count drops by as much as 90% in the first 5 to 7 days. This is one of the greatest benefit of storage. The optimum period for storage of water is about 10 to 14 days. Second process is filtration. The stored water we can take or send for filtration. Filtration is the second stage of water purification at large scale. It is very important stage where 98 to 99% of the bacteria are removed apart from other impurities and gives very clean water. Two types of filters are used for this process: slow send filters and rapid send filters. So what are slow send filters and what are rapid send filters, we will discuss now. Slow send filters. Slow send filters are also known as biological filters. The various elements of a slow send filter are supernatant water, a bed of graded sand, an under drainage system, and a system of filter control valve. Why it is slow sand filter? There is the sand is not slow. Actually, the process of filtration is slow in slow sand filters, while in rapid sand filter it will be fast. This is the basic difference, and how it is achieved we will see. Here, in slow sand filter, directly the stored water is taken or flown on the or passed on the sand bed. Okay, let us see first what is supernatant water. The supernatant water is the water volume which is above the sand bed. The supernatant water which is above, it is normally the depth is kept 1 to 1.5 meter and it remains constant. It provides a constant pressure on the water to filter down and to overcome the resistance of filter bed and to promote downward flow of the water through sand bed. The supernatant water provides waiting period of some 3 to 12 hours depending upon the filtration velocity. For the raw water to undergo partial purification by sedimentation as well as filtration. So here in the supernatant water is purified by two ways, sedimentation as well as filtration. Now sand bed. The most important part of any filter is sand bed. The sand bed is same in the rapid sand filter and slow sand filter. Firstly, the upper layer will be fine sand and approximately 1 meter. The sand grains should be perfectly round and have an effective diameter of 2 to 3 mm. This sand is should be clean from the clay and organic matter. This sand bed is supported by graded gravel of 30 to 40 cm deep, which prevents the fine sand to be carried out into the drainage pipes. So here, by this picture you can understand that this is the space for supernatant water, then fine sand will be there, then graded gravel, first smaller size, then medium size, then larger size, and then there will be perforated pipes or drainage system which take out the filtered water. Water percolates or filters through the sand bed very slowly. It is subjected to a number of purification during this process, that is mechanical straining, sedimentation, absorption, oxidation, and bacterial action. The designated rate of filtration of water normally lies between 0.1 to 0.4 meters metric cube per hour per square meter of the sand bed surface. When the filter is newly constructed, it acts only as a mechanical strainer, but soon the surface of the sand bed gets covered with the slimy growth, which is known as vital layer or biological layer. This layer is slimy and gelatinous and consists of thread-like algae and numerous forms of life including plankton, diatoms and bacteria. The vital layer is very important. It removes organic matter and holds back bacteria and oxidizes ammonia into nitrates and helps in producing bacteria-free clean water. Until the vital layer is fully formed, the first few days filtrate is usually considered as waste water. Under a drainage system, at the bottom of the filter bed, there will be a drainage system. It consists of porous or perforated pipes which act as outlet system for the filter. Once the filter bed has fully formed, the under drainage system cannot be seen from outside, but it is there below the sand bed. Now, filter control. The filter is equipped with certain valves and devices which are attached to the outlet pipes. The purpose of this device is to maintain a constant rate of filtration and control the outflow. Now, rapid sand filters. Rapid sand filters are also known as mechanical filters. And here, the process of filtration will be faster than the slow sand filters because there are certain more activities or processes which are included or involved in the rapid sand filter. Before going to the filter bed, the water is treated 3 or 4 times. How you can see by this system: coagulation, rapid mixing, flocculation, sedimentation, and then filtration. After this level, here the remaining process will be same in the as we have seen in the slow sand filters. Okay, so first we will see what is flocculation, coagulation. The raw water is first treated with a chemical coagulant such as alum to clean the water. The dose of alum vary from 5 to 40 milligram or more per liter depending upon the turbidity and color, temperature and pH value of the water. The alum water is then sent to the mixing chamber. The mixing process uses the mechanical rapid mixing of the blades to mix the raw water with the alum completely and evenly so that alum can act on this water for coagulation. Next phase involves the flocculation. In flocculation, there are flocculation chambers. The water which is mixed with the alum is sent to the flocculation chamber. And here there is mechanical steering, slow mechanical steering of this water in the flocculation chamber so that flocculation occurs or proper coagulation occurs in the water. The mechanical type of flocculators is most widely used in all the filtration process or water treatment plants. It consists of a number of pedals which rotate at the rate of 2 to 4 RPM. Now, the next step will be sedimentation. This coagulated water is passed on the sedimentation tanks, where it allowed to stay for the period of 2 to 6 hours. Here, due to the coagulated material is settled down with impurities and bacteria at the bottom of the tank and clear water remains on the top. The precipitate which settled down, also known as sludge, is removed mechanically from time to time from the bottom. There is a system in the bottom without disturbing the operation of tank. And the water which is above is partially clear. Now, this clear water is sent for filtration on sand beds. And now, this water is already clear, so the process of filtration will be rapid. The partial clear water is now sent to sand beds of rapid sand filter. The depth of sand is usually same, 1 meter supported by graded gravel and the under drainage system. Then below there pipes are there which collects the filtered water. Here, this is the flow diagram of rapid sand filters. Here there is water source, and while coming the water into mixing chamber, alum is added. And in mixing chamber, the alum is mixed with the water. Then there is flocculation chamber. From flocculation chamber, it comes to sedimentation tanks and then on filter bed. After filter bed, there is addition of chlorine. This is also known as disinfection. And then clear water storage or reservoir will be there before sending it for consumption. So the third part after storage and filtration, there is disinfection. At final stage, sometime this disinfection can take place at two levels, pre-filtration chlorination or pre-chlorination and post-chlorination, where the facilities are available. Otherwise, at one time it can be done. Disinfection of clean water is carried out by adding chlorine to it, because chlorine is bactericide. Chlorine kills pathogenic bacteria. Apart from its germicidal effect, chlorine has several other important functions, such as it oxidizes iron, manganese, and hydrogen sulfide and destroys some taste and odor producing constituents. Disinfection of clean water is very important because it should be clean and safe to drink before consumption. Large scale water purification in this way it is completed, and this purified water is ready to consume and sent through the water supply system or pipes of water distribution department to the households or end user as tap water. Thank you students for watching such videos. You can subscribe the channel, and for getting updates you can like Facebook page of My Student Support System. And for making your notes, this is Blogger, and in subscription box you can also see the link of this blog. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and join Facebook group Nursing Notes. Thank you. Have a nice day.